Hi, I'm Rami Tamimi.
Today we're going to be staking out a building. Now this building has six corners to it, and at every corner there are two 10-foot offsets. Let's take a look at my computer screen and see what I'm talking about. Right here is the building that I'm referring to. Points in circles here are our control network. We're just gonna have two control points, 101 and 102. This L shape right here are the corners of our building. Points 5, 7, 11, 12, 14, and 8 are the physical corners of the building. All the offsets, with exception to point number 2 and point number 17, are 10 feet away from the point that they're referencing. So 1 and 4 are referencing 5, and they're 10 feet away. 6 and 9 are 10 feet away and referencing 7. Because L is an inside corner, its offsets are going to be variable. Now this is a project where we're going to assume a coordinate system. Your control points may already have coordinates that you're going to be using. However, we're just going to go ahead and assume that the northing of point number 101 is 5,000 and that the easting is 10,000. Now looking at these plans, all we have to do is very simple addition. We're going to go ahead and calculate the coordinates of these points, and then we're going to input them into our data collector so that we can begin serving. One thing that this map is missing is that there's no north arrow, so I'm going to go ahead and make the assumption that north is up. All right, with that assumption made, we see that we're going north 55 feet, but we're not going east or west anywhere. So our easting is going to stay the same, and our northing is going to go up 55 feet. So the new northing becomes 5,055 and the easting is at 10,000. All right, now we're going to go ahead and take a look at our points. We're going to jump around a little bit, but based off of what we're working with, the easiest way to calculate these coordinates is to go by columns or rows and just work your way across. When I look at number 3, I can see that, again, it's on the same line. So I'm just going to say that the easting is also 10,000. The building dimension is 35. There's 10 feet to the north and 10 feet to the south to get us to 55 between the control points. Therefore, the distance between 101 and 3 is 10 feet. So our northing is going to be 5,010. Now let's take a look at 2. It looks like the dimension between 3 and 2 is 11 feet. So all we're gonna have to do is add 11 feet to the northing of 3. So that puts us at 5,021. Easting is the same, so we can just keep that at 10,000. All right, the distance between 2 and 1 is 24 feet. So we're just gonna go ahead and add 24 to the northing of 2. So that gives us 5,045. And the easting is still 10,000 because it's in the same column. Great, we got the first column. Now let's go ahead and calculate the next column. So when I shift over here, we look at point number 16. 16 is along the same northing line. We're not going up in any way. So the northing will be 5,000. So let's go ahead and write 5,000. And this is also shifting at 10 feet. So we can now add the easting at 10,010. Next point we're gonna look at is point number 8. It looks like we're going to go up, and this is the same easting because we're not going left or right from 16, but we're just going up 10 feet. So point number 8 is gonna be 5,010. And the easting will just be 10,010. We go all the way up to point number 5. Between 8 and 5 is 35 feet. So we're going to add 35 feet to the northing of 8. So that puts us at 5,045. And that makes sense because we're in line here with 1 and it has the same northing as 1. Easting stays the same as 8, 10,010. Finally, point number 4. We're 10 feet north of point number 5. So we're just gonna add 10 feet. So that's 5,055, and the easting is the same at 10,010. All right, let's do the third column. So for point number 17, we're along the line of 16 and 101, so we're gonna have the same northing of 5,000, so we can write 5,000 here. Now we are moving east 19.67 feet from point number 16, so I'm going to take the easting of 16 and add 19.67, so we're at 10,029.67. So because of the shift in the north of 19.67, that's going to be the easting of point number 17. Let's go up to number 11. 11 is going to have the same easting because it's not going left or right of 17, so we can write the easting down 10.0029.67, and it looks like we're going north 10 feet and then another 11 feet, so we're going to be going north 21 in the northing for point number 11, so that's going to be 5021. Next point is number 7. We're going to add 24 feet to the northing, so the northing will be 5045. Easting stays the same, 10029.67. And point number 6, we're going to add another 10 feet, so it's going to be 5055. Easting is the same. We'll come over here to point number 18. 18, the northing is going to be 5000 because it's in line with the other points that are 5000. We're moving over 10.33, so that means that our easting is going to be 10040. Next point is point 14. We're just literally going north 10 feet, so it's going to be 5010. Easting stays the same as 18, 10040. Next, we're going to go north 11 feet to get to point number 12. So the northing is going to be 5021. The easting stays the same at 10040. Next, we're going to point number 10. So you're going to just add another 10 feet, and we have 5031. 10040. Last column, point number 15 is already 10 feet off of our initial 5000 line, so that means the northing is going to be 5010, and we're going over 10 feet from point number 18, so the easting will be 10050. Next point is point number 13, and it's literally just north 11 feet, so point number 13's coordinates will be 5021, and the easting is the same at 50050. Looks like we missed number 9. I think that's just because it's in its own little line, but that's okay. We can look at point number 7's coordinates, and it seems like it's not going up or down at all, so the northing is going to be the same as point number 7, 5045. And we're moving to the right 10 feet because it's an offset, so we'll just add 10 to the easting of 7, 10039.67. And there you have it. That is the calculations to figure out the coordinates of all the points for our L-shaped building. Now, depending on the type of brand that you use for your total station and your data collection, it's gonna depend on how you can export this data. You could just manually input all this data into a text document and differentiate the point numbers, northing and easting, by using a comma, or if you tab over and use a space. You could also do this on Excel. It might be a little bit easier because you have full control of putting in the numbers yourself. Once you've gotten your project name, you wanna either save this as a text file or as a CSV file. Those are the two most common file extensions that most data collectors will understand. After you've saved it, upload it to your data collector. Usually you can do this through USB or through the computer. And once all that's been done, we're gonna go ahead and pack up all our stuff and head out to the field. Hello and welcome to the field. We're gonna go ahead and establish our control points so that we can begin our stakeout. Now for point 101, we're gonna be using our infamous blue point. I've gone ahead and labeled it 101 just so that we know where we are located. For the purposes of this lab, we're only going to be using a tape to establish the second point. Usually in the industry, you may set the point first, take an observation, and establish a distance, and using that very accurate distance, establish the coordinates of the second point. But for educational purposes, I'm just going to go ahead and pull 55 feet and establish point 102. Then getting as close as I can to the point, I'm going to go ahead and drive the chaining pin into the ground so that it's aligned with our point. Now I'm going to go ahead and pull this tape 55 feet. And as we near into here, you can see we're at 55 feet.
Stretch this out and pull tight on the tape. We're going to pound in this hub. So we're going to put a stake right here.
Now, what we're gonna start out by doing is occupying this first point, 101. If you haven't seen my video on how to set up a total station, I'm gonna recommend that you click on the video in the top right-hand corner. It highlights the details of what goes on in a survey total station setup. Watch that video first before you continue with this one. Then once you've seen that video, come back to this video to see the rest of the stakeout procedure. I'm gonna go ahead and set up a prism rod here on our point 102 so that we can backsight to it from our total station. And then we can just go ahead and position this to point towards the total station. Now I'm gonna go ahead and sight the prism so that we can get our backsight reading.
Good, move it to the right, move up a little bit.
Okay, I did not expect that. Wow, okay. So this number usually has some error in it. I hit 55 right on, so expect about 5/100ths of a foot of error when you use the tape, maybe up between 5/100ths of a foot and a 1/10th of error. Or if you're like me, you'll get it right on. Remember, you're measuring the horizontal distance, not the slope distance. So, okay, so 55 feet between point 101 and point 102. Now, just like the traversing video, we're gonna be establishing our point of occupancy and what point that we're backsighting. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and start by going into survey, and then we're gonna go into stake points. Now we are occupying point 101. The instrument height is irrelevant since we're not doing any kind of elevation, so you can just put zero. The point that we're backsighting is 102. And once again, instrument height, irrelevant, so you can just put zero. Backsight. And we're gonna go ahead and check and go ahead and set our angle, and it's gonna go ahead and set our horizontal angle, and we can check and continue. Now, we're gonna go ahead and start staking out points. I'm gonna go ahead and start with point number one. Now, it's good industry practice that if you have a fixed rod with a prism on it at all times on a point, and you're going to be staking points, that you put this rod down. That way, your robotic total station isn't going to accidentally sight to this prism and throw off your staking. If you're using a traditional total station and you don't have robotics, this isn't really an issue, so you don't have to worry about it. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and lock our instrument to our total station. If you don't have a robotic total station, you're gonna have somebody behind your instrument sighting your rod at every shot. I like to raise this above my head so that I don't block it, but we'll go ahead and search. Okay, we're locked in on our total station. I prepared a number of stakes that we're going to use to stake out our potential building. Remember, this is how our building looks like with all of its offsets. So these stakes will be representing the location of that building and the offsets. All right, to figure out if we're close to the point where it needs to be staked, we're gonna go ahead and take a reading and see what our total station tells us the distance is from our current location. I'm gonna take a reading, make sure we're nice and plumb. Okay, so in relation to our total station, point number one is located 6 feet away from the total station, which is what OUT stands for, and 2.28 feet to the right of the total station. So you would have to also move right 2.28 feet. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pace back about 6 feet. My pace is a little over 2 feet per pace. So I'm gonna do three paces. 1, 2, 3. And then I'm gonna pace to the right 2 feet. It's about one pace, which is 2 feet. I'm gonna go take another reading. All right, and here's what we've got. Now we need to go out of the instrument 0.5 feet and go to the right 0.3 feet. Very minimal movement. I'm gonna go out 0.5 and go to the right of the instrument 0.3. Let's go ahead and try that. All right, and after doing all that, now I just says go in 1/100th of a foot, and I'm right on between right and left. So I'm gonna go ahead and stick this rod into the ground.
Place a stake in this location.
All right, that'll do. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and ask to stake out point number two. All right, and then it says I need to move in about 23 feet. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, in about 5 more feet and to the left of the instrument, 1.5 feet. Okay, you go out. Okay, let's try that. Right of the instrument, 0.4 feet. Okay, out 1.16 to the left, 0.04. All right, there we go. Lift it out of the place, put it in here, pull out our hammer. We'll go ahead and switch to point number three. All right, it says I need to move in about 11 feet.
Okay, out 2 feet and right 1 foot. Out 2 feet and right of the instrument 1 foot. Try right here. Okay, out 0.7, left 0.6. So out 0.7, right 0.6. Out half, right 0.3. All right, right here. Take out our hammer.
All right, let's do point number four. Alright, and there you have it. I've now staked out all of the points that we calculated. And with that, I will see you guys next time.